Hi and welcome back to my channel. Let's say that you just finished writing your scientific article, you're about to submit it to a journal and you just realize that actually you have to submit also the word count. A LaTeX package which works flawlessly and it allows you to count all the words inside your document. Let me show you how it works, how to install it on your computer and how to get started. I will show you all the basic commands and how I structure my project. Here on the left side, we have a lot of files, but mainly the only file that we're going to use in this tutorial are main.txt file, which is our main file, our main LaTeX file. We have the PDF that we are actually visualizing here on the right side of the screen, where we have our article, and then we have a few images and another section that we're going to import later. Let's see how TeXcount works and how to install it on our computer first. First of all, you need to check if you have TeXcount installed on your computer. That's pretty simple, because you just have to write in the terminal TeXcount-h. In VS Code, I have the terminal here at the bottom of the screen. Of course, you can also open the terminal from your computer. That's the same thing. I'm going to use the terminal here at the bottom of the screen so you can see everything that I'm doing. I'm going to type TeXcount.h and I see a message here, which means that actually TeXcount is installed on my computer. That's great. If you don't have TeXcount installed on your computer, you can open MicText or any other LaTeX distribution that you have installed on your computer and you can install it over there. In MicText, you just have to open the console, you go into packages, and then here you search for TeXcount, and then you will see that here I have TeXcount already installed. Otherwise, I could have pressed the plus button and install it. TeXcount is actually a Perl script, so it's not going to work straight away on your computer unless you have Perl installed on your computer. But don't worry, Perl is free and you can install it using this website. Just do a Google search, which is Strawberry Perl for Windows. You will be redirected to this page or something similar, and then you can download Perl for your computer. And you can find a tutorial online if you don't know how to do it, but it's a pretty straightforward process, so I'm not going to cover it in this video. Let's go back to VS Code and see how we can use TeXcount. Now that we have TeXcount installed, and we also have Perl installed. So let me clear the console here and the terminal, and let's start with the first command, which is TeXcount, and then the name of the file, so we can count the words inside our LaTeX file. Let's see the results of TeXcount. We get the encoding of the document, we get the words in the text, we get the words in the headers, and the words in the caption. Later on, we will see how TeXcount is actually counting this word and what is actually including. We have one word in the caption, which is actually here, the caption of this figure. And then we have one figure, which is correct. We only have one figure and no tables in our document. And then we have no math equations and no math displayed in lines. At the bottom here, we can see in the subcount a detailed description of what we have here. So we have 43 words here at the top, which is basically in the abstract part here. So inside here we have 43 words. And then we have 92 in the introduction. And also in the introduction, we have one word, which is the heading here, introduction. So we can see that Federico Tartarini here counted as two words. Then we have the background section, which has 91 words, and the comments, which is this section here, which has also 91 words. This is great, but we want to get the sum, because here we get all the number of words in individual part of the document, but we have to manually sum all these values together. So we can easily get that by just using the command sum. If we write TeXcount-sum main text, we can actually see here a sum count. Another thing that you can do, another option that you can pass, is total. So we say dash total. And then in this case, we are not going to see the sub count at the bottom. Another thing that we want to check is if this text count is actually counting words in other sections of the document that we are importing using the input or include command. At the moment, it's not going to count it. straight away. So we have this section here. So we have section.txt here. So we have some text inside here. Let's go back to the main document. And now we're going to add this section here in our document. We can add this section using the command input or include only. I have already explained how to use the input and include command into your document. So I'm not going to cover it again in this video. Just check my previous video if you want to find out more. Here you can see that new section has come up and it's called additional section. And here we have all the words inside the additional section. Let's see if something in our total count has changed, because of course we have added a section, so we are expecting that we have more words in our document. So we run the same command as before. So if I run this command again, we have again 323 words, which is definitely incorrect. So in order to include sections that we have imported with the command input, we have to add another option, which is -enc, which stands for include. Let's run the command again, and then we can see that something has changed. So the sum of the counted word is now 416, which is great. Let me remove actually this total flag here, because I want to show you all the results that are actually displayed by let me actually clear the terminal. Let me run the command again here. So we can see that we have a lot of information here. So we get the here where we run the command. So we have how many words are in the main.txt file, how many words are in the section.txt file. And then here, if you go at the bottom, we get the total words in the main.txt file, which compiles and comprises both the files, both the section and the main.txt file. So here we get our summary. Another thing that I really want to show you is the verbose option. Allows you to quickly visualize and clearly visualize how LaTeX is actually counting the words. So let me run that by adding a V option here in the command. So we have to say TeXcount. In this case, we don't really are interested in sum and total. We just want to say include, because we want to include the section that we are adding. So I press enter and you will see that we get a lot of output here. Let's try to quickly visualize this, and later on I will show you also another very nice thing that you can visualize all these using an HTML file. But let's take step by step. So here, after running this command, TeXcount include -v main text, we can see here the output and what TeXcount is actually counting as a text. In this case, it's highlighting in blue all the text that is counted as a text, in light blue the header and titles, and then in blue again the caption, text and footnotes. It's also showing us that in red we will have all the parts that are not counted. We have in yellow parts that are also not going to be counted, and so forth. So here there are all the information. Let's go back to the output of our file, where we are interested. Well, we can see that all this part of the document is not counted as text, and that's correctly done, because we definitely don't want to count these words, because these are just import statement to import the packages required to generate the PDF, but these are not words in our paper. And then we can start seeing here that the title is actually considered as text, while my name is considered as heading. And we saw already that before, but this actually clearly clarifies that. We can see more information, and we can see, for instance, that here are all the words that are have been counted. Here we can see that the introduction again is considered as an heading, and all this part here is considered as words, and they are counted. This is a great output, but could become a little bit daunting to read if you have a very large document. So let me actually show you how to export this all in an HTML file. So I have already the HTML file here, so let me delete this file, because we want to move it to recycle bin here, and we're going to use this command here, which is I'm going to explain it in a second. So let me show you the command. This TeXcount -v, v is for verbose, and then we have HTML, so we want to output as an HTML file. Main.txt is the file that we want to actually analyze, and we have to use also the include command here. So we have to add inc, And then we go here and we output as a temporary file, so tmp.html. Okay, so this temporary file doesn't have to be temp, it could be temp1, temp2, or you can just change the name as you want. So this file here was generated, so right click here and I open it in File Explorer. So here I have the file, I'm going to open it with Opera, doesn't matter, you can open it with any web browser. And here we can see the same output as before, but nicely formatted. And we can see that, for instance, all the text inside this verbatim environment has been considered as not as text, because it's in fact not text inside our document, is if it was a figure or something like that. So text count is actually not counting that. Here we get a summary again of all the words inside the main file, inside the sections here, and then we get information about overall our paper, and we get the all words in the text, words in the headers, and so forth. Let's go back to VS. Well, one thing that we checked before was this command here, which is text count sum including, and here we have the two file. Of course, if you want to have a less verbose output, we could have used the dash merge command, and this would have just printed out information. Again, we could have used the total. So again, it could have been even less information. And finally, we could have used the command of -1, and this would have returned only the number of words. So if you really need the number of words and you don't want to have all the verbose output, this is the command. So the last thing that I want to show you is how to ignore some sections. Let's say that you have an acknowledgement section and you don't want to count it because or an appendix, you don't want to count them because the journal author's guideline say that you don't have to count acknowledgement in the word count. So we can wrap any section that we want to exclude from text count and from the counting of the words with this command here, which is percentage sign followed by TC, both capitalized, semicolon, and then ignore. And then at the bottom, we just have to say end ignore. Let me run again the command that we ran before, and you will see that now we have way less words because we have excluded that section. So basically, this was it for the text count package. I really hope you find this video interesting and useful. If you did, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. If you want to support this channel, you can do so by buying me a coffee. A link on how to support my channel down in the video description, or you can also support me on Patreon. Thank you very much and see you in the next video.